Wonderful story of love. The love of our Lord Jesus Christ to mankind. The man who died on the cross of Calvary for you and I to be saved. He was brutally wounded for our transgression. And I want to say good morning to somebody today. As we normally say here, I believe because it is a global program. Some are in the afternoon, in the evening. Some are sleeping. Some are still, you know, preparing to go to bed. I believe every day is 24 hours before God. And I want to say to you that good every time in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because God is awesome, because he's powerful, because he's glorious, because he's kind to his people, I want to say to you this morning that today shall be a glorious day to you in the name of Jesus, because the Lord will bless you as the word is coming today, because today is a wonderful day, it's a new day, it's a new dawn. And everything concerning you shall be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is International Christian Association. You know, to so many of us who have been part of this program, we do tell you that it is not a church program. It's a ministry that God has given to us to, you know, we meditate about the kingdom of God, the kingdom of God, the kingdom to come. It's about telling people what they need to do to prepare for the kingdom that they are expecting from Jesus Christ, the kingdom of the Father in heaven. What he's saying to us is that he wants us to know what we need to do to make heaven real unto us. And this is what God is sending us to do at this time. And I want to tell somebody today that today shall bring about the joy that we need unto your bosom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That yes, as you think about it, God will make it happen in the name of Jesus. To so many of us who have been part of this program from this time, you know that yes, God has been a blessed God unto his people. If today is your first day of watching us on this program, if you want to know how far we have gone, you can visit our YouTube as you have it on the screen. You know, YouTube, just search for Prophet Olotu. You know, ICA, you will get everything, you know, in total. Because God is awesome in heaven and is looking for somebody to be blessed. And I believe you shall be one of those that God will bless today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yeah, International Association has some programs that God has given unto us, you know, to decode for his people at this time so that people can be blessed. It's a fellowship whereby people want to come and share together the giftings of God in their lives and hear the undiluted word of God that you need to do what to hear to know how to serve God better. It's not a message that you want to tell people, you know, before you say you look onto faces and eyes and position of people. It's a place where you tell people the raw word of God, undiluted word. No, it's as if it is not as if it is not as if. No. The word of God is sharper than two-edged sword. That anywhere it goes, it makes corrections and tender people towards the kingdom of God. That's the reason why we are here, to share yet another thing unto us today about God. You know, we have places, we have our fellowship on the screen. Very soon you have it. You know, two places in London here. You know, one in Shatton, one in Dagenham. You know, I have my numbers on the screen if you want to know more about it or another program we have. Then you can ask me, I will tell you how to go about them in the mighty name of Jesus. Some other program we have, two retreats every year, May and October. Then one night vigil of every month, third Friday of every month. The Lord was one who ordered us to do this for him. He said, go and do this and do that and do this. I want to meet my people, and thank God that he has been meeting his own people accordingly on those programs. It shall be well with you as you beckon to somebody this morning around you who's very close to you or far to you. Thank God for technology. You can reach as many places as possible to contact somebody, tell them that program is on. Listen to that word of God again and again. And when you do it better, you will enjoy God better. It shall be well with you this morning as you call unto somebody to listen to this program. Why don't you look for your Bible? Because we'll enter into the word of God together this morning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And fasten your bed because the fly is about to trick off. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And before we move on, my name is Prophet Lanrolotu. And the other man will be coming together, all these wise evangelists. Raphael Omotayo Ajiboye, we are here together again today. Before we move on, we want to commit the programs to the hands of the Lord as I invite the man of God to pray for a short while. Over to you, sir.
Our Lord, our God, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give you thanks for this hour.
Yes,
and
Lord.
All the hours.
Yes, Lord.
You are the owner of the world.
Yes.
You have sent us to deliver your messages to your people.
Yes.
As we are here today, to speak your word.
Yes.
Speak out to your people today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That your word today.
Yes.
Deliver people.
Amen.
From any form of ignorance.
Amen.
And bring an understanding to every life.
Amen.
So all we know that there's only one God.
Amen.
And we continue to declare your praise on the earth.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Why don't you say big amen at home? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Unchangeable God. Unchangeable God. We give you glory. Unchangeable God. Give you glory. Unchangeable God. We give you honor, unchangeable God, King of glory, unchangeable God. Yes, we reference the name of our Lord Jesus this morning, the unchangeable God, who reigns forever, the same yesterday, today, and forever. You know, he wants his people to know one thing that is very unique this morning. It is unique to every individual because that is what is happening around us today. And the Lord has given all this word to give to somebody today. You know, God said he wants to heal people today. God said he wants to make a way. He wants to make a way for people to move today. The Lord said somebody is going to watch today that, yes, you don't have anything. It's as if things are becoming too low for you. Things are coming, you know, going out of hand for you. The Lord said they want to make provision for you today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Lord is coming to visit somebody today as we speak here by the mercy of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
And what is it that God is having for somebody here today? It's very simple. The Lord said the healing time. The healing time. The healing time. And the Lord made me to realize that the whole world is sick. Sickness has covered the land. Men are sick. Women are sick. Both young and old are sick. Cities, in fact, so many things have gone out of hand, which cause sickness to man. And, you know, for us to understand what we are seeing this morning, we must bring our mind home that what is healing matters to us. What is it about? It is when somebody is sick or there is illnesses in someone's life that that person needs healing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I simply make it for us to understand this matter. Healing is to make somebody or a thing to be well from their sicknesses and their illnesses. Healing is to make somebody come out of all his sicknesses and his illnesses in whatever area somebody is sick. Healing is to make you out of that sickness, that weaknesses of the body. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I want us to know this morning that the whole world became sick since that mistake of our forefathers, or let's say our forefather, Adam, and our foremother, Eve. That when man disobeyed God, when they disobeyed God, then sickness covered the land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what does the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 34 says to us this morning? That is where we're going to start this morning.
Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow.
Do not worry about tomorrow.
For tomorrow we worry about its own things.
Tomorrow we worry for itself.
Sufficient for the day is its own trouble.
Every day has its own trouble that is sufficient, that is too much to handle. Every day, as the day breaks, as you are praying for a blessing in every day, don't forget that there are troubles around that might not allow that blessing to come through. Why? Because something happened in the book of Revelation, chapter 12, from verse 12 to 17. But you know, in Genesis chapter 3, we're not going to read that one, Genesis chapter 3, you will see that that was where Satan, that we're about to read, you know, mingled into the life of that woman called Eve to deceive him against the mind, the purpose of God for their lives. The land that was okay, that it was well with, The garden where the enjoyment was, the garden where there was no sickness, the moment Satan came in there, the moment Eve received that deceit from Satan, all this thing came into the life of man. What does he say in that Revelation chapter 12, sir?
Therefore, rejoice, O heavens.
Rejoice, O heavens.
And you who dwell in them.
And you that dwell in heaven.
Woe to the inhabitants of the earth.
Woe to the earth where we are in.
And the sea.
You can imagine if heaven, where God stays, where the angels were dwelling, where the hosts of heaven worship the Lord, where we have tabernacles of holiness, rejoices, because somebody was sent out of their kingdom. And the Bible says, woe unto the earth where we dwell in, because that man was casted. What? Yes, sir.
Woe to the inhabitants of the earth.
Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth.
And the sea.
And the sea.
For the devil has come down to you.
The inhabitant means we that is living there. And everything in the sea. Because devil has come to take over the place. No wonder we have so many, you know, spirits in the sea. Does it come to trouble the earth where we are in now? Because Satan has taken over the whole place. And he brought something into our life, which is called sickness. And the whole world is sick of what we are going to see now. Yes, sir.
Having great wrath.
Having great wrath.
Because he knows that...
Anger. Terrible anger. Trouble in his hand, because he has come to trouble man.
Because he knows that he has a short time.
Because he knows he has a short time. And the only thing that could have made us to, to escape this trouble, we miss it. By the instructions of the Lord, not to do this, not to do this, not to do this. Everything that is causing sickness into our lives today, into our bosoms today, into our flesh today, is as a result of so many things that we allow devil to plant into our system, into our lives. Disobedience caused so many of it. Disobedience caused so many of it. Because we want to do things in our own way, not in the ways of the Lord anymore. Cities are sick. Nations are sick. The whole world has become a sick place. There are so many things that does not go well anymore. Marriages are sick. Relationships are sick. Friendships are sick. Because people want to do their own thing, not the things of the Lord. And God is saying to us this morning that this day is a day of healing to somebody. Amen. And the Lord will heal your infirmities in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your home shall be healed.
Amen.
Churches are healed.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mosque, they are healed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, the moment you love to do the things of the Lord, you become God's own. God is, he's not a religion man. God is not a religion man. Amen.
Amen.
He's a God of righteousness. When we give all our blessings, all our inheritance unto Satan, he exchanged them with sickness to man. What we're supposed to do easily to enjoy life, we struggle to achieve them now. In attempt to achieve them by force, we cause troubles into our communities, into our lives, into our homes, where the husband wants to live above the wife. They're supposed to be one. where you want to live above somebody supposed to be one, you cause trouble to your marriage. Where a woman who's supposed to live, you know, humbly with his wife, I mean, husband, want to have the head over, live above the husband, trouble comes. Where everyone want to become a pastor, either you are made to be so or not, they want to have leadership role at all costs. They cause a lot of troubles in the church, even in the mosque. There are so many challenges in the city. There are so many shrines where killings are taking place because the land is sick. The mind of people is sick. When the mind is sick, then it will transcend to communities, to nations, and to churches. The mind of Eve was sick. He accepted Satan to take over from the land. And see what is happening today. But I want to tell you today that you need this healing of the Lord. And that healing will visit you.
Amen.
That healing is knocking at your door.
Amen.
That healing is knocking at your office.
Amen.
That's where you are ruling as president. Healing will take place today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Look at what the book of Psalm, chapter 6 from verse 1 to 10 says.
Oh Lord.
This man knew what was going on and he knew what he needed to go for. When somebody is sick, and he does not recognize that, he doesn't discover that, he will die in that sickness. When your house is sick or troubled and you cannot think about it, that house will die in sickness. When your life is sick and you cannot think about it, you think, yes, things are okay. When things are no more okay, you will die in that sickness. This comes to the man or this man of God that called David that we're about to hear now. Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Do not rebuke me in your anger.
Do not rebuke me in your anger.
Nor chasten me in your hot displeasure.
Please don't chastise me in your displeasure. Because when Adam and Eve, when they misbehaved, they bring anger of the Lord over themselves in the Garden of Eden. Many are bringing anger of the Lord over their lives today because of what they do. And it's causing trouble. It's bringing sickness to lives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's bringing sickness to people. Yes, sir.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
He now said, have mercy on me, O Lord. I believe so many places need the mercy of God today. Homes need mercy. Nations need mercy. Communities need mercy. Kingdoms need the mercy of the Lord. That your house need the mercy of the Lord. My life need the mercy of the Lord. If you want God to heal your land, we need the mercy of the Lord. And I believe the mercy of the Lord will visit somebody today.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Oh, Lord. For I am weak.
For I am weak.
Oh, Lord.
I am sick. I am sick. I am weak. Because I am no more of you anymore. I am of myself. Therefore, God, have your mercy on me because I am weak. I don't know how to pray again. I don't know how to seek you again. I am doing my own thing now. Not what you wish. But God, come and help me. I need your mercy. If you are sick, you need the mercy of God today to awaken you from your sleeping, from your doziness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Heal me.
Heal me.
For my bones are troubled.
Because he knew that he was sick. David knew he was sick. Somebody who was the heart of the Lord. Someone of the Lord. He was just bathing one day. I mean, he was just looking through his balcony one day. Saw another man's wife bathing. And he killed the husband to have the woman. Because his heart became sick. His mind became sick. His thought became sick. When a mind is sick, the whole body becomes sick. That is where you project your thinking. That is where you carry out your service. That is where you carry out whatever you need to do day by day. David, that was a man of the heart of the Lord, allowed devil to take him over, and he killed. And don't forget, the laws of the Lord say, thou shalt not kill. After he realized that man must not kill, he now came to God. I am sick. Heal me, O Lord, because my mind is sick. If you are a president of a nation, if your mind is sick, you can't be bothered if you kill the whole nation for you to reign as the president, as the prime minister. Is that the king? So many people sell their friends so that they can have their ways. You are sick. When somebody leaves the things of the Lord for his own, he becomes a sick man, a sick woman, a sick brother and sister. You become a sick wife, a sick husband. When you don't allow the mind of God to prevail over your dealings anymore, then you are sick. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Yeah, what happened thereafter, sir?
My soul also is greatly troubled.
My soul is troubled now. Somebody who was enjoying, you know, fellowship with God, like Adam. Somebody was enjoying fellowship with God. And when he had sinned against God, God came to the garden. He said, Adam, where are thou? He said, I am feeding myself. That is what is happening in so many homes today. The Bible says, can two work together except they agree? Many families don't agree anymore over the will of God. They prefer to do things separately. Such a family is sick. Oh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Such a home is sick. Oh. Such church is sick. Because you will do things in your own way. But do you know the day of judgment is coming? We are not getting there yet. Yes, sir.
But you, O Lord. How long?
How long?
Return, O Lord.
How long will I be in this sickness? Lord, I need you. Lord, how long will nation remain in this sickness? We need you. Like I was saying this morning, like my country in Nigeria and in Africa, where I come from, that country is sick. We need God. The healing of the Lord must visit that nation. I don't know where you come from. Either yours is Asia, whatever nations you come from. Everywhere things are not working well anymore. Killing is rampant. They need healing. Such a nation will receive healing this morning in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because if you have a gun in your hand, if you don't press, if you don't shoot, that gun cannot kill anybody on its own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, Lord, how long will I remain in this sickness? I need your mercy. Our thinking needs the mercy of the Lord to do things rightly with God, with the mind of God. Enough is enough. Even in the churches of God, in the mosque, you say, when evil is rampant in the churches and in the mosque, what will you expect on the shrine? Hallelujah.
Amen.
What will you expect on where people are ever ready to slaughter? Yes, sir.
Return, O Lord.
Return, O Lord.
Deliver me.
Deliver us, Lord. Oh. We need you. We can't do it again. We can't do it alone again. The whole world is in rampage. God, help us. Help us. As we are coming this morning, the man of God was just chatting with me, said, one of our daughter in Nigeria, our son in Nigeria, entered into a bus. You know, he didn't know that everyone in that bus were thieves. They took everything, including his shoe.
Somebody who went out to go to work, he dressed up, they took everything, purse, you know, everything from him. He didn't know that everyone in the car, in the bus, were thieves, they were gangs. A public transport. It's all over the world. Not Nigeria. I'm just using that as an example. You don't trust anybody anymore. The whole world is a rampage. We need the healing of the Lord. Now, yes, sir.
Oh, save me for your mercy's sake.
Oh, save us for your mercy's sake. Yes, sir.
For in death, there is no remembrance of you.
Oh, there is no remembrance of you in the grave. He now said it is now we need you. That's okay, sir. It is now we need God's help, mercy. Because the whole place is in trouble. The whole place is in trouble. Man want to do things in their own way. You know, somebody that was created by, when you are not an animal, created by God as a man, you change yourself to woman. And, you know, the thinking is no more right. With the purpose of God. You know, I am not talking about chemistry here. I am not talking of an engineer here or a medical doctor here. I am talking as a servant of God here. That God said, go and tell the world that a day is coming. You can see change your mind now. You can see change your mind now. With all those mistakes you have made, you know, maybe you have turned yourself to a woman and you want to come back as a man, it doesn't matter. Why don't you go to God and say, Lord, I am sorry. Let your heart be consecrated. And the moment you are changed from it, you know how to convince others not to do it again. That's what we are talking about. We are not embarrassing anybody. We are telling you the gospel truth of the Lord. That God said this is the reason why our world is facing trouble today. Because Satan is here. He will be ministering to so many hearts. Like he did to Eve. And the moment you don't allow the mind of God to take over the mind of Satan, sickness will come to that mind. You will be taking evil. We are talking about the healing of God today that is coming to somebody that is hearing me. The healing of God is coming to somebody that is hearing this voice of the Lord today. He said they want to go through, he want to pass through lands today. And I believe the word of God is powerful. More than two-edged swords. Anywhere it goes, it brings salvation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's see what Psalm 41 says, sir. From verse 1 to 11.
Blessed is he.
Blessed is he that consider the poor.
The Lord will deliver him in the time of trouble.
The Lord will deliver you in the day of trouble. The moment you think you are in power, and you don't consider other people that are very poor, and because that power they have given to you for you to look after them, and you want to use that power to ruin them, to damper them, to destroy them, to downgrade them, to walk over them, then the Bible says, blessing will not come to you. Maybe that's the reason why your home is not blessed. That's why your church is not blessed. That's why everywhere around you is not blessed. We are not talking about the blessing where you embezzle people's money. That's not the blessing we are talking about. There are so many of you, you have children, but you cannot point to a good one out of them. They are all bastards. Because they cannot emulate any good thing from you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Like father, like son, like commander, like daughter. And the Bible says, Jesus Christ said, I am a replicant of my father. Whatever you see my father doing is the same I am doing here with you. A compassionate God, a merciful God, a loving God, a holy God, a God of righteousness. You are a church goer. You say you worship the Lord. And people can't see the traces of a childhood in you. A day of judgment will come. You can see change from this, your sickness now, your illness is now. It is not somebody who's in hospital lying in that pain that we are talking about. If his mind is right with God, he will achieve home. If you are not in a sick bed and your mind is polluted, doing evil, forget about the kingdom of God. You can see change now. Including me, if my way does not go with the Lord, all this what I'm saying will judge me one day. And the Lord said, I am going to judge the attitude of people against my will when they get to heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are a rogue, continue to thief. Begin to steal. If you are an adulterer, continue in it. Tell them they are saying nonsense. But a day will come like that a rich man, that there will be no shortcut. It is now you can change. So that we don't have a polluted world. We don't have a polluted nation. You don't have a polluted family. And the community will enjoy the will of God towards man accordingly. Yes, sir.
The Lord will preserve him and keep him alive.
The Lord will preserve such a person and keep him alive.
And he will bless on the earth.
And he will be blessed on the earth that you dwell in. That is what God wanted for man. Yes, sir.
You will not deliver him to the will of his enemy.
He will not deliver you to the hand of your enemy.
The Lord will strengthen him on his bed.
Will strengthen him on his sick bed.
You will sustain him on his sick bed.
When you are a man of God, when you do the will of God, he will heal you in your on your sick bed. Anywhere you are, anywhere you need healing, he will just visit you. And say, let there be healing unto you. Let your will do the will of the Lord. Your own will to do the will of God. And let God take over. That attack of the enemy of Satan is the one that will come and heal you if you are his own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
I said,
Lord,
be merciful to me.
Be merciful unto me.
Heal my soul. For I have sinned against you.
When your soul is healed, then you arrive with God. You will not be sick anymore. He said, heal my soul because I am sick. I said, when you are sick in your mind, in your soul, then you will be sick all over because you'll be thinking evil, how to kill, how to destroy, how to take over, you know, how to terminate that person from his marriage, from her marriage, from that place of work. This is the reason why we have troubles around the world today. You know, the car you want to take from that person does not belong to you, it's not your own car. Why are you waylaying him? Why are you stopping him? Why are you taking what does not belong to you from that person in the first place? You are not the one who buy the car. The house does not belong to you. The money of that country does not belong to your family. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The day is coming. It doesn't matter how many churches you build for people. It doesn't matter how many mosques you build. A day is coming that God will say to you, you have done air. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
My enemies speak evil of me.
They will speak evil. If you don't do the will of God, your enemy will speak evil against you. But when you do the will of God, when they speak evil against you, leave it to God and let God judge them.
When will he die? And his name perish. And if he comes to see me,
he speaks lies.
His heart gathers iniquity to himself.
I'm coming, sir. Lies has taken over the whole place. Somebody who is taking evil against his friend, he will still come to laugh with him or her. How are you, my friend? I love you. I love you, love you, love you. Even husband to wife, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Whereas, he's thinking of how and when will he die? When will she die for me to take over? And when you kill him or her here, don't you think there's going to be a place of judgment? There's going to be a place of judgment. The judgment of God is not the judgment of man here. Where you change judgment easily, pervert judgment easily, is a true judge that we are going to meet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how eloquent you are as a preacher. It doesn't matter how knowledgeable you are as a minister of God. If your ways does not suit him, it is now you can still receive his healing. Yes, sir.
Well, his heart gathered iniquity to himself.
His heart gathered iniquities to himself.
Well,
I'm coming, sir. Hello, good morning, caller.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. I believe you are enjoying the word of God this morning.
Yes.
If I'd known, I'd like even say I don't need any caller, but you have spoken.
Okay.
No, let's go on. Yes, sir.
Amen.
God bless you, sir.
I want God to expose every enemy that is pretending as my friend.
Uh-huh.
God should expose them.
Yeah.
And put them to where they belong.
You heard what God is saying this morning.
Yes.
If your mind is right with God, are you with me?
Yes.
If your mind, your soul, does not think evil against other people around you, I declare this morning, because at times I don't want to pray, on unfaithful prayers.
Okay.
That when somebody is not right with God, at times prayer will not go, will not be answered. But when you are right with God, in your mind, in your soul, when you don't think evil against anybody, a prayer like this will just go and do what God says you will do. And I declare this morning, by the mercy of the Lord, all your enemy will come to bow for God in your life. In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
The Lord will bring that to your feet. In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
The man to do the will of God more.
Amen.
I release upon you now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know what God is showing to me is very powerful.
Mm.
God is showing me the sign of love towards you.
Amen.
Oh my God. Please. Don't change your ways with God.
Amen.
So that this love of God will permit forever for you.
Amen.
It is well with you, sir.
Amen. Thank
in
you very much.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, go and read Psalm 122. Okay. Just read that Psalm for 12 times to enjoy God more. Oh my God.
Okay.
God bless you, sir.
Thank you.
And whatever you, God gives to you in your dream, that is your blessing, your inheritance.
Amen.
He says something for that, sir.
When he goes out,
he tell it.
All who hate me whisper together against me.
All that hated me, they whisper together.
Against me, they devise my heart.
They devise heart against one another.
And evil disease.
And even there are evil disease all over.
They say cling to him.
And now
that he lies down.
That he lies down.
He rises up no more.
Oh, God bless you, sir. The evil is too much in our lands. It's as a result of Satan that was casted into this earth.
Hello.
And God wants you. God bless you. Hello. Good morning, caller.
Morning.
How are you?
Well, I want the Lord to guide me to the right church.
Okay.
Because I've not been successful.
Oh my God.
Times. Yeah.
Lord, thank you, Father, Lord. This is the kind of prayer God is expecting from his people. Lord, because your daughter wants you to lead her to the right church where she will serve you, Lord, you must not mislead her, God, yes. Holy Ghost. Because if you don't guide her right, where she will not be misled, not just a church, it's a spoken word of church, not a spoken word of God alone, where your spoken word is being practiced.
Amen.
Send your daughter there in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And may God empower you to serve him.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father,
thank
Lord.
You, Lord.
Thank you, Jehovah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Father, Lord.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I believe my God will do that. You know, he did mine. Then he will do yours. Go and read Psalm 137, okay?
Yeah.
Just read that Psalm for about 9 times. And the Lord will lead you to that rightful place of worship. I trust God for that. You will come back to give your testimony about that. and the Lord will not mislead you. Congratulations to you. Go and read Psalm 137 nine times. It is well within Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Healing of souls, healing of life, healing of mind is what we are talking about this morning.
Amen.
It is well with you, sister.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes, sir. That's finished. Hallelujah. Let us see what the book of First Chronicles. Is that a new color? I can't find it on the screen. There's no new calling on this screen. First Chronicles chapter 4.
Now Jabez was more honorable than his brother.
Verse 9 and 10. So that people. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Hello, good morning, ma.
Good morning, brother.
God bless you. Is this sir or ma?
It's a ma. It's a woman.
Oh, it's a woman. God bless you. Yes. What do you want God to do for you this morning? I believe you've been hearing this word of God this morning.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the Lord said they want to make a way for you.
Amen.
Yes, the Lord wants to make a way for you. Amen. Everything, that place, they think you won't pass through. The Lord said he will take you through it now.
Amen.
Yeah, what do you want him to do for you? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes?
I want you to pray for me. I will need to but my spiritual life is not stable.
Your spiritual?
I'm a minister of God.
Okay.
But my spiritual life is not stable.
All right. Lord Jesus, why don't you lay your two hands on your bosom, please?
Okay, I'll do so.
Maya Daya Rabba Sandakaya Bosuriha. Lord Jesus, and Solomon said, why don't you give me your spirit? Give me wisdom and knowledge to direct your people. Your son realized that he's no more the same person of old like David did. He needs your mercy.
Yeah.
That he visit him in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Like never before.
Amen.
Rise and walk in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Christ. That your lowliness is taken over by Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That willingness is cancelled by his fire.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I release the awesomeness of the Lord and his unction over your life anew. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
May the Lord create a new heart unto you.
Amen.
To worship him anew.
Amen.
To seek him anew.
Amen.
To serve him anew.
Amen.
Every weaknesses, every willingness, oh yeah, disappear. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Christ. Go and manifest
Amen.
In the power of the Lord.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. And amen.
Amen.
You know, man of God, go and read Psalm 51.
Amen. I will do so.
Go and read that Psalm for about 14 times.
Okay, but, sir.
The Lord wants to visit you anew as you required.
Amen.
And go and join with him in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you, sir.
Amen.
God bless you, ma.
Amen. Thank you. For
it is well with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Chronicle, First Chronicle, chapter 4, verse 9 and 10. What does this say?
Now Jabez was more honorable than his brother.
Now Jabez was honorable more than everyone around him.
And his mother called his name Jabez.
And his mother called his name Jabez.
Saying, because I bore him in pain.
Because I gave birth to him in pain.
And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying,
Because of our own pain, he gave name to his own son. There are so many things like that in so many lives today. But when Jabez realized that he was sick, his life was sick, it was not the story he had about himself that he's enjoying in. What does he do? Yes, sir.
And Jabez called on the God of Israel.
And Jabez called unto the God of Israel.
Oh, that you.
You need to call unto God in your nations today. The whole world needs to have a day of prayer all over the world to call unto God. To heal our lands. I believe the Lord will give you for that one. Where in the G8 meeting, G20 meetings, this proposal will be presented. that we need prayer for the whole world. One day fasting and prayer for the whole world. Either you are a Muslim, either you are a churchgoer, either you are a worshiper of iron, whatever. That we need God to look down again to save us from this perishing. The world is perishing. The land is sick. And Jabez realized that he was sick. And he called unto the God of Israel. If you don't realize that your home is sick, you will think things are all right. You will not call unto God. Because you have money, and you and your wife, you just do your own thing in the house. And because you have money, you have position, you think it is okay. When you get to heaven, you will now see how God judges people over marriages. Over relationship. That person you call your friend. That was why I said, thou shalt not kill. You must love one another. Because when you get to heaven, that something God will put your way, that will put my way, that I might not even have answer to. It is now you can see, come out of that your sickness. Tomorrow might be too late. Yes, sir.
And
Jabez called unto the God of Israel, say,
oh, that you bless me.
Oh, that you bless me indeed.
And enlarge my territory.
And enlarge my territory.
That your hand will be with me.
That your hand will be with me.
And that you keep me from evil.
If you don't pray unto God, that wish around you, that evil man around you, like we read in that Psalm 41, that when you realize that people around you, they are not good friends, if you don't pray to God, they will destroy your life. They will massacre your life. But when you come to the God of Israel to save you, to deliver you from their hands, I can assure you, God will not hesitate. He will do better than you required from him. I pray for every nation today, every home today, that all this healing needed is needed that God will look down from heaven.
Amen.
And begin to visit them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you know your home need that now, you better begin to say amen. If you know that your children need that, say amen to that one.
Amen.
That your job need healing.
Amen.
In every areas where we need healing, Lord, heal us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And to everyone who wants to call in, but maybe your calling is not coming in, or maybe the word has even taken you over. In every area you are sick. In every area you have been devastated by Satan because of his coming to this earth. And you believe in God of Israel. May he heal you this morning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say be healed.
Amen.
Be healed.
Amen.
Be healed.
Amen.
Be healed.
Amen.
Let every government be healed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every kingdom where leadership are taking over from Satan this morning, you will enjoy God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Everyone that need you this morning, I believe they have received you. And if you are watching this morning, you have not given your life to Jesus, the author and the finisher of lives, the one that can heal, you know, easily. I believe by next week we'll continue in this healing. You will see where Jesus healed people. There's no infirmity he cannot heal. He will heal without stress. He will not take one from you and added another sorrow like other healers of the world does. He will heal you and the healing will be complete if only you allow your soul to be healed with him. And that place where you are healed, you are sick, the Lord will heal you as you listen this morning. And I pronounce that to you this day in the name of God the Father,
amen.
God the Son,
amen.
God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
See, we come back the same time next week, people of God. I commit you to the hand of God that your healing is permanent.
Amen.
And so shall it be.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
For me and for the man of God, we say, God bless you. God loves you. Thank you.
watch over us. Shepherds with wonder receive it. Say now, what you believe.